lovely to see you tonight. Welcome to Southend High School for Boys for the second night of our two-night run of Christmas concerts. I hope you're having a good build-up to your Christmas. I wonder if there's any gentleman in the hall, aren't there, who hasn't actually started their Christmas shopping yet. Looking forward to that week. Shopping. There's still time, fellas, that's the way I see it. We hope you have a wonderful evening. Second half of tonight is all about this celebration. There'll be a chance to sing. So do give the person next to you a smile in case you're not very good at singing and you need to make friends by the end of the night. It is good to see you. Well, thank you for your support and we do hope you enjoy yourself very much.
Take a job in the city.
much, ladies and gentlemen. I've really enjoyed conducting the Melbourne Esquire staff. They're a wonderful bunch of people, and I think we're very fortunate in this school to have some very able and some very willing senior students. And this is our first example tonight of a group that has been entirely led by students for the whole term. And they're far more inspirational than us music staff would ever be. And we have set up this new group. They premiered last night. And it's an intermediate big band. So it's filling the gap between our junior jazz band and our senior jazz band. And as you hear, you'll hear in just a moment, they've filled the gap, quite high end of the gap. And it's really impressive what they've achieved in one term. So I'll hand over to Andy with our intermediate big band.
Thank you.
gentlemen. We're going on now to our junior jazz band, led very ably by Tom and by Ewan. You will have noticed perhaps Max, Andy Berry has been working with Max Brook to lead the intermediate, the band of Max was buried in the rhythm section, helping with drums and amps and stuff like that. But Tom is here. He'll have his back to you as well when he's conducting. And Ewan is the considerably taller chap. He's sorting out guitars over there. So these two gentlemen have led this band for me. This band gives young players an opportunity to play in a popular style and plays it some improvisation as well. There's such a well-cultured audience, ladies and gentlemen. You started clapping the solos in jazz. Can anyone inviting you? That must mean you're really relaxed and happy and know you're playing jazz. So well done. How are we doing, Ewan?
Thank you.
Can I, once the little concert band, our junior players on stage, I'll tell you a story about the first time I played solo when I was tiny small, and I stood up with my oversized trombone and I blew and nothing happened. And I got tiny cramps and everyone was looking at me, and I looked out like a frightened owl in the audience with wide eyes and sat down again, not having made a noise. And I think the reason, for many of us who are musicians now, the reason that we are adult musicians and we keep going is because from the youngest age, someone gave us to say, you're playing an instrument, that's great, and you perform as well. You get on the stage, you perform and you play. And it has to start somewhere. For me, it started with beautiful silence, which many people say is the best sound. They come out the trombone anyway. And for some of the, some of the more experienced players, and you see some older helpers, but for some of the guys behind me, last night was their first opportunity on a stage to perform, having learnt an instrument from scratch in September. And I want them to have this stage, and I want them to play to you, because do come back in 7 years and see them with their professional diplomas going on to a music college or university, because it will happen. It will happen. And it happens every day. So, far better than I did. Here's our little concert band.
Thank you.
guys. Well played. Great to be one to be shipped. But yeah, do feel free, ladies and gentlemen. Let's move on to our chamber orchestra now, and I'm very proud. The guys have worked very hard on this arrangement of Scheherazade. Arabian style music by a Russian composer. It's going to be very evocative, in terms of dramatic, and beautifully lyrical and dance-like. And everyone's ready, so I'll stop talking and begin the music. It's Scheherazade.
Thank you.
reached the end of our first half, and I always ask this, it's very embarrassing for my wife, but is everyone having a good time? Is everyone happy tonight? And enjoy the music?
Yes.
And anything else, just sorry. After the band played Wicked, I do believe refreshments are served in the pavilion and in the canteen. Could I ask please that you wait until all of our performers are back at the hall so there's not such a crush at the doorways? You will need a drink for the singing in the second half, though, so do find your way in then. Thank you very much for your support this half, and I'll see you in about 20 minutes after this number. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sorry about the kerfuffle, ladies and gentlemen. I'm giving you the ladies and Protestant to carry on stage. Yeah, thank you. Right. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the start of Christmas for many people. I don't know if anyone in the hall has sung a carol yet. Some people have, some people haven't. Some people hate it, some people love it, but we're going to sing O Come Ye Faithful now together. I do love it. I think it brings us a community sticking together. You're part of our community at school here tonight. We've got the wonderful Joe Zammit, former student, to come in and play organ for us tonight, which is really helping me now. Can we give him a little round of applause? And if you have been able, please stand and we'll sing the three verses of the Herald King. That's embarrassing. Together, thank you very much. Let's go.
Everything came into existence through him, Not one thing that exists was made without him. He was the source of life, and that life was the light of humanity. The light shines in the dark, and the dark has never extinguished it. God sent a man named John to be his messenger. John came to declare the truth about the light, so that everyone would become believers through his message. John was not the light, but he came to declare the truth about the light. The real light, which shines on everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into existence through him. Yet the world didn't recognize him. He went to his own people, and his own people didn't accept him. However, he gave the right to become God's children to everyone who believed in him. These people didn't become God's children in a physical way, from a human impulse or a husband's desire to have a child. They were born from God. The Word became human and lived among us. We saw his glory. It was the glory that the Father shares with his only Son. A glory full of kindness and truth. John declared the truth about him when he said loudly, "This is the person about whom I said, the one who comes after me was before me, before he existed, because I did." Each of us has received one gift after another, because of all that the Word is. The teachings were given through Moses, but kindness and truth came into existence through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. God's only Son, the one who is closest to the Father's heart, has made him known.
the journey.
Inquiring diligently about the star, they referred to Professor Brian Cox,
who thought it was amazing while smiling in a constant and strangely unsettling way. In Harrods, the camels made a mess all over soft furnishings. On the underground, commuters glared at no smoking signs as incense wafted gently through the carriages. And when it came to the great day, they saw the entire voting population slumped on sofas by 4 o'clock, rendered senselessness by too much dead poultry and the Queen. While over Liberties and Hamleys, the flickering angels sang, "Glory to the God in the High Street." And they found him, with the inns full up again, in the old familiar place, bringing their unregarded gifts to the empty stable of the human heart, where the infant Christ is born, again and again and again.
So on to the final of our groups tonight, ladies and gentlemen. This is our ukulele band, led by Song. Am I on? And it's grown somewhat since last year, regular attendees at the concert. Song seems to be very popular. But also, I know he's had some help with Nick as well. He'll admit that some guys have been there for all the time, doing good songs and having a lot of fun. So it's wonderful to see. I think they're very nearly ready now. Are you set? Not quite ready. Well, they're worse than waiting. Would you get me across a Christmas joke and a rhetorical question?
To my shoulders, near about my name. Whoa.
to the safety choir. Thank you very much, guys. Just as they're getting off stage, two things that struck me tonight: how wonderful it is to see so many former students back in the audience tonight, former members of staff, people that have been associated with the school. Thank you, as always, for your support and your encouragement. And I know it means the world to the students behind me when you come and you encourage them and you do what you do. So thank you for that. Some of the things that makes our school community more than just a school. I also have in my hand a winning lottery ticket. I mean, lottery, do I mean raffle ticket? That'd be nice. Winning raffle ticket on the blue 36, blue 36, apparently looking with a Mr. Rowe, whose son is in 7SD1 and in the concert tonight. So, well, maybe not, okay. Maybe cheers and congratulations to Rowe and money raised tonight by the raffle is £371. So, thank you very much.
Santa's bad day, the birth of a tradition. One particular Christmas season, a long time ago, Santa was getting ready for his annual trip, but there were problems everywhere. Four of his elves got sick, and the trainee elves did not produce the toys as fast as the regular ones, so Santa was beginning to feel the pressure of being behind schedule. Then Mrs. Claus told Santa that her mum was coming to visit. This stressed Santa even more. When he went to harness the reindeer, he found that three of them were about to give birth, and two had jumped the fence and were out, heaven knows where. More stress. Then, when he began to load the sleigh, one of the boards cracked, and the toy bag fell to the ground and scattered all the toys. So, frustrated, Santa went into the house for a cup of apple cider and a shot of rum. When he went to the cupboard, he discovered that the elves had hidden liquor and there was nothing to drink. In his frustration, he accidentally dropped the cider pot and it broke into hundreds of little pieces all over the kitchen floor. He went to get the broom and found that mice had eaten the straw at the end of the broom. Just then, the doorbell rang and a very irritable Santa trudged to the door. He opened the door and there was a little angel with a great big Christmas tree. The angel said very cheerfully, "Merry Christmas, Santa. Isn't it a lovely day? I have a beautiful tree for you. Where would you like me to stick it?" Thus began the tradition of the little angel on top of the Christmas tree.
Even better. And I only ask one thing of you. I'm going to ask you keep that message going for us, would you please?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's wonderful to have you, and we are done. So if you're happy, we hope you have a wonderful Christmas, but let's stand and sing. It's okay when you pay for now, isn't it? Let's stand together and sing the 3 verses straight through.